What's up, guys? It's King Daddy D-Mac, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Minecraft. We're in my single-player survival world. Oh, yeah, and we can see the light. Oh. Anyway, guys, how are you all doing? Today, we have a special episode. Yeah, if I can actually get into the right mood. Yeah, we today are going to go on an epic adventure. That's right, an epic adventure. And today, why is it a special episode? Well, we're going to do something called a walkie-talkie. And that's something... Ooh, loud. We got to get that set up to work with Hoppas. The Hoppa. Anyway, today's going to be a special episode where last time I asked everybody if they could... give me some questions that they had for me, and while we go on our epic adventure, I could try do my best to answer them for everybody, at least as many as I could. I got so many questions, and a lot of good ones. A lot of them I've answered before in the past, and a lot of them were brand new, never answered before. So I thought I'd mix it up a little bit, do some of each. I'm just really quickly trying to finish getting ready, make tools and whatnot. Let's see, what else do we need? Let's get a shovel, let's get an axe, boom, boom. Make another backup pickaxe, and I think we're good in a sword for now. I think that should be everything we need. So, we're gonna get started, and the main part of our search is we gotta find ourselves a mule, or a donkey, or whatever that jack bung thing is. Hello guys, how are you doing today? Doing good. But you know, I found this kind of weird. Look at this. When I want to combine these two, it costs me 33. I switch it around, it's 29. And really what I want is a power, like power three or above bow, an infinity for our journey. So if I take this infinity and power four book, pretty common. Look at that, only 9. Still don't think these things are very balanced. But anyway, spend a little bit of time over at the base, fixing things up. Finally, getting myself organized and put up frames. Been working a little bit on trying to get something done. Some forward momentum or progress in the base. Started lining everything with iron. Not sure if I really like that. I don't know. And I've been putting in some more secret lighting. Of course, due to our witch farm, we get all the glowstone we want. Glowstone all day. Okay. So, let's dump out this extra stuff. Here's everything I got in my ender chest. And, I don't know, a bunch of random stuff. Really, food, some spare tools, other ender chest, iron, saddle, leads. I think that should be everything we need. We are going to run over to our horsey part, and we'll start up answering questions, and I don't think I'm gonna get through all of them today. One thing that I did was I first was going to say everyone's name to ask a question, but it really ended up being too long, and I kept on having to look at my little question sheet and then sit still and be like and it just wasn't working out. So I combined a lot of the questions so I'd be able to answer multiple at once. And I'm not going to be calling out the people's names that actually asked the question. But that's okay. That's not why people ask the questions in the first place. But maybe what I can do is put a list of all the people's names whose questions I addressed. And I may miss some. I'm sorry if I missed yours. But I'll do my best. Do my best. Oh, good lord. Already off to a bad start. So anyway, I'll meet you guys over where our little horsey area is, and we'll start off over there. And start off, let the questions commence. All right, guys, got a brand new day over at the horse area. I went ahead, I picked out a horse. We got, I'm gonna name you Dusty. Trusty old Dusty. It's gonna be our companion for today, if I can get this freaking lead off. Come on, get off there. Awesome. So Dusty may get left behind, but we are going to be on a search for bigger and better things. Hopefully we can get some horse armor, find some dungeons, find some, I don't know, maybe even a jungle temple, witch hut. Who knows? Who knows? It could be a lot of cool stuff. But anyway, let's get on with the questions. I've been a little nervous about this. I don't know why. I really am not sure why. I've done this a million times. But I usually try not to think too much about what the questions are that people ask, just so I can be a little spontaneous, even though I know what they all are. I just haven't really thought about the answers yet. Anywho, first of all, some things I wanted to address. A lot of people asked what's going on with the computer. Have you ordered it yet? Has it come in yet? Do you already have it? What the heck is going on? Oh, jeez, how are we going to run into water right away? Oh, this is going to be a nightmare. Maybe I shouldn't have went this way. So anyway, here's the deal. I ordered the computer. It's been almost a month now, and I went through iBuyPower.com, which I'm not sure. I've heard good things about. I've also heard some negative things about, but for the most part, it seemed good, a-okay. What I did order, and it should be coming in, according to them, it should be coming in probably sometime early next week. And I haven't decided if I'm going to do an unboxing yet. I don't really have a video camera. I don't even have a webcam anymore. It's really horrible. That's another thing that I need to get. But what I ended up getting, I ended up ordering an i7-3930 at 3.2 gigahertz. And not the top of the line, but pretty dang good. And that's Intel. I ended up going with, I wanted the, what is it, NVIDIA? I wanted to get the 780, but I ended up going with, for video card, the 680, and it's like a super clocked version or something like that. It's kind of nice, saved a little bit that way, and it's still, I guess, kind of one of the better ones that you can get, but it should be very good and help a lot with rendering. Went with 32 gigs of RAM, so plenty there. You could go up to 64. But that just, I don't know why I'd ever need that much. And yeah, it's got all sorts of crazy, like, what is it? The hydro cooling or water fluid cooling. I don't even know what you call that stuff. I'm not, as you can tell, I'm not a huge techie guy. And yeah, I went with two hard drives. One is the solid state. And that's what I'm going to have all my operating system and everything on. And then I also got, I think it's a 2 terabyte. Oh no, you're stuck on a cactus. Get out of there. A 2 terabyte secondary hard drive, and that I'll have for all my video recordings. But yeah, I'm pretty happy about it, and I cannot wait for it to come in. A lot of you have been also asking what I currently have for a computer. It's kind of interesting. I haven't talked about it much. I currently use a laptop, and it is a Lenovo. Is that how you say it? Lenovo? Yeah, it's basically the old, what IBM changed into. IBM used to do laptops, and I guess they sold out to another company, Lenovo, and it's been good for me. That's what all my videos, like all my YouTube career, actually I started off on a, it's ancient by now. I shouldn't even bring that up, but it's been alright for me. The biggest problem had been it overheating, not necessarily its performance. What has been interesting, a lot of you probably noticed, what's this? Have noticed my frame rates on a lot of, videos more recently have improved vastly, and a lot of people have been wondering what's going on with that. I actually have been, I guess you could say, kind of borrowing my brother, when he's around, has a pretty nice gaming laptop. Again, still does have overheating problems, but actually has a decent video card in it and will let me use it from time to time. So a lot of my recordings more recently have been off of that, and then I'll end up doing all, I'll just use a, what's it called? External hard drive, and then render it and edit it on my own. But very nice of him to let me use it. Again, I do not recommend any laptops for YouTube use or making of videos just because of that possible overheating factor. It's really hard to get something that's good. And then also, if you want to upgrade it, it's just a pain in the butt. On my laptop, I've upgraded. I think it's running at like 8 gigs of RAM, which is still kind of pitiful for a YouTuber. But anyway, I'm very happy. Ooh, emeralds. I'm very happy, and I thank you all for helping me get here. Woo, we got horse armor. Finally, finally. Look at me, I'm already... We don't need three boats. We probably don't need any boats. I'll grab the gold. All right, so we're good here. We'll leave the TNT. So that is the deal with the computer. I'll do something special for when we get it. And if I don't do an unboxing, I'll at least do me first going onto it once it's hooked up, because that's kind of the more the fun part, to actually see it running and working. But that should hopefully be sometime next week. It really kind of sucks having to wait so long, but when you don't build your own computer and you have them do it, you got to wait for them. I'm not even sure if they keep all the parts on hand or if they, with the custom, because it was all a custom order. It's not one of the ones they already had made up. Which probably would have been really fast if I did it that way. Plus, I didn't do any faster shipping methods or anything like that. Just the normal. Because that stuff, it already, it's pretty dang expensive. For the monitor, I did purchase off Newegg, what is it, Asus monitor 1080, which is pretty nice. I just went with whatever their top recommended one was. So anyway, that's the deal with all the computer stuff. As far as another thing, another that's kind of important, I should let you guys know, and I guess it's kind of too late now. As far as Minecon, I do plan to go. I've already booked a hotel. I've already booked my plane flight for going, and I think it's what, Saturday and Sunday. I'm going up on a Friday, I think, and then I leave on a Monday, maybe something like that. Now here's the problem: Minecon tickets sold out in like, I was there all 3 days when they were selling them, and literally in less like in the first like 3 seconds they like sold out, or else you just couldn't order them, and I didn't end up getting a ticket. Nope, no ticket for me. So I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna do. I've talked with a couple people, and kind of what I'm waiting on is to find out if any extras end up coming up, and I'm pretty hopeful about it. I think there was something though with the tickets, were, you know, in case people were trying to scalp them, I think you have to show an ID at the door or something, so you can't really sell tickets if you bought too many, and a lot of people did that, bought like 6 tickets all at once, just with the hopes of either giving them to their friends or selling them on eBay. Ooh, we got horses. Any mules? Mule. No, just horses. All right, not what we're looking for. So anyway, that's gonna kind of screw those people, I think. Ooh, look at the baby horse. They're not gonna be able to sell their tickets or give them away to friends. So hopefully, somehow with that, I'll be able to get some type of extra or something. But I really don't know. I'm a little nervous about it, but I'm hopeful. All right, so on to the other questions. Most of the questions today are fairly simple ones. And they're probably the more I divided them up. And these I called the more personal questions, the like non-Minecraft ones, or just more things asking about me or real life. A lot of them I've answered in the past, but finally out of this freaking jungle. But anyway, let's see. What is your real name? It's a mystery. No, I've said this plenty of times before. My real name is Dave Mack, and yeah, that's my name. My name is Dave. Is that your profile picture really you? Yes, my profile picture is really me. It's me wearing sunglasses. It's from, I want to say maybe a year or two ago, 2 years ago, something like that. And I guess, and sometimes when people see other pictures of me or in real life, it doesn't look exactly like me, but it is me. It's just, I guess sunglasses really make you incognito. So it all depends, but yes, that is really me. And I hope, now that we have the new computer, how are we going to get around here? I hope to be able to do some live streaming or show, what's it called? Show myself in some videos. Like this would have been a great video to do that, but I don't have a webcam and my current computer, I don't know if it could really handle the rendering of multiple videos all into one. Oh, and by the way, made a bed, so we're gonna sleep through the night. So went through the first day. It's been about 10 minutes in beyond the initial intro. Let's hop off. Come here. Let's set down a fan so you don't run away from me. And lead you up to that. All right, we're good. So that should be something, hopefully, into the future that we will be able to see more of me. And I'm a little afraid about streaming. I'm not sure how well I'll do with that. It's kind of hard. I think it's streaming's really difficult. It's really easy, and I think that it's really would work well for me because I do play a lot off camera. Just, you know, and I'd be able to actually show more of that. But at the same time, I'm a little nervous about the whole interacting with the audience. It's just not something I'm used to, but I guess you have to do it to get better at it. And it's definitely something that I recommend to a lot of people if you're trying to get more noticed. And I just think overall it's fun. I really want to interact more often and better with you guys. I'm not the best about with social medias of staying consistently in touch with you guys as far as what's going on and everything like that. And I think, don't do it again. I think streaming would be pretty ideal for that. We didn't go over this mountain yet, right? Oh, which way did we come from? Oh, I always do this when I'm talking. See what I mean? I cannot talk and pay attention to the game at the same time. Okay, so I forgot what I was talking about, but let's move on. D-Mac, what is your favorite color? My favorite color is blue, different shades of blue. I like a lot of colors. I also like red. I like green. I like black. I like a lot of colors. When I was a little kid, my favorite color is purple, which is kind of funny. I find a lot of people, actually when they're younger, tend to like purple. I guess it's considered the royalty color or something, but I don't know. Blue's my favorite color. Blue. What is your lucky number, D-Mac? I don't really have a lucky number. I'm not a big gambler or anything like that. I guess, you know, it's seven. Seven is considered the lucky number, so I'll have to say that's my lucky number. Although I'm not too big on those type of things. Do you play any sports and or follow any sports? And specifically, the two sports that people ask were football and wrestling. Wrestling, no, I don't follow wrestling. When I was a little kid back in the 80s. Wrestling was pretty big back then. I'm also from Connecticut, which I think a lot of, I'm assuming you're talking about like the TV wrestling that you see. I think that started out of Connecticut. I think so. I know Linda McMahon, she's run for different offices in Connecticut. Ooh, any witch huts? But yeah, I guess I was like in the era of Hulk Hogan. I remember like in the Ultimate Warrior, but not Jake. Oh, it's the other ones I remember. Jake the Snake, Macho Man, Randy Savage. Yeah, they're all wrestling in when I was younger. But I'm not an avid follower. Football, I'd have to go with either the Giants or the Patriots, both being close to me. Again, I don't really follow any. It's really kind of a commitment, I think, to follow sports. And I just don't have the time. Doesn't mean I don't like them. I just don't have the time to be a true fan. But yeah, I guess that is that question. As far as sports, I played when I was younger hockey, I played soccer, I played baseball, you know, all those little league teams and such. In high school, the only sport I played was lacrosse. I thought about playing baseball, but they're both during the same season, and I'm not a bulky enough person to play football. But yeah, I played lacrosse for a couple seasons. It was fun. It's a good game. I like it a lot. It's a lot more fast-paced, and that's kind of the sports I enjoy playing, or faster-paced sports. But nowadays, I'd have to say if Minecraft was considered a sport, that's the closest thing I do to it. I guess I do, and this goes into the next question, what else do you like to do other than playing Minecraft? And playing video games. I during the winter I'll snowboard, which I haven't been as good about lately. Ouch. But I really enjoy that. When I was younger, I used to skateboard. Every so often, you'll see I'll like a skateboarding video from people. And I don't really follow it. I don't know who all the big pros are now, but I do enjoy watching. I think it's pretty cool. Another jungle temple. Ooh, we should put the horse armor on this guy. That wouldn't be a bad idea. What do you look like? Ooh, that's pretty cool. Looking snazzy there. Looking snazzy there, Dusty. Yeah, so when I was younger, I skateboarded, and I did that till I was maybe like 16, and then got into snowboarding also. I still snowboard, and I ride a Burton. What is it now? It's called like a. See, that's bad. That's how much I'm getting old. Getting old. BMC, I want to say. It was before they had those. I don't even know what the latest technology is in snowboarding. I remember right after I got it, they started with this like honeycomb design for the boards, and I was pretty pissed about that. I don't use the snap-in bindings. I use the tie-in ones, which I prefer. I just like the feel on my feet. But that's that. Let's see, other things I like to do. I like camping. When I was younger, I was a Boy Scout. Always be prepared. I didn't really start getting into video games until I played video games when I was young. Like, I was around when the first Nintendo came out. My first system was an Atari. We got flame. No. Come on, give me something good. Why all this gold? I don't even need gold. All right, nothing good in you. Let's see. So, but yeah, I didn't beyond, I want to say like earlier elementary school and high school, I didn't play many video games. I don't know, it was just more social. And then I started getting back into video games when I was, I guess, like maybe my sophomore year of college. I started playing more. And I think like around the time Grand Theft Auto came out, that was one of the first games I got back into just because it was so crazy having like such an open big world. I just couldn't believe it. I remember playing Tony Hawk Pro Skater, the first one. I enjoyed a lot. That was though when I was in high school that came out. I think so. So where was I going? I even forgot what the question is. Other games, but yeah, getting into YouTube. I got into YouTube from Pokemon, which a lot of the questions today are asking about Pokemon. It's kind of funny. I don't even know. When I was in college, a friend of mine liked Pokemon. Who was that? Liked Pokemon, and it was just something fun that I could like on a portable system be able to like take with me on the bus or just when I was waiting for a class or whatever, and just something goofy, nothing too complicated. And as I started, you play any game, you start to get into it more and more. And I really like the concept of that you kind of like collect your characters and it would continue on. It wouldn't just like end. And I always had kind of, I got like a pack rat mentality where I just like hoard things. And I guess I got into like just collecting, trying to catch all the characters in it. And then after I finished with that, I slowly got into the battling aspect. What do you actually do with the characters once you have them? And I went on like any person with a video game. You're trying to figure out stuff. You go on forums, and I ended up, that's I think when I first started even watching YouTube, is looking up stuff about that game, and I came across battling, competitive battling. And some of the first ones, people that I saw out there, Maryland was out there. He's a newer member on the Hermitcraft series, and a lot of you guys, if you're an older subscriber, of course you know him from my Pokemon days. I didn't actually know Marilyn then, but was one of the first people. I think the first YouTuber, he doesn't have a channel anymore. The Shadow Project was his name. Was also is probably my favorite YouTuber for at least Pokemon stuff, competitive battling. But anywho, so that's how I got into it. And it just kind of carried on. I saw some videos and I was like, you know what? Once I actually started getting better at it, I just thought I could make a better video than this person. And just for fun, went ahead and did that. And And actually, the videos did well. I mean, of course, being a starting YouTuber, you're only getting maybe 100, 100 views is like, oh my god. But, you know, I my first week got up to over 100 subscribers, if not, yeah, I want to say my first week, and maybe even higher than that, maybe like 300, and it was just, it was really cool, and I really enjoyed the rush of other people watching the videos, and, I don't know, doing well. So it just, it was a hobby, and that's how it started off. That's how I got into YouTube. It ended up with Pokemon. I went a little overboard on it, I want to say. I continued on longer than I probably really would have with the game had I not been YouTubing. But again, you know, because you enjoy making videos. And it just got to the point where I started getting sick of the game. And, you know, I stopped. I switched into Minecraft. And I do play other games, but Minecraft is a really easy game to YouTube. It was a game, I'm trying to think, I think just some older friends of mine recommended to play it, and I just, after the first couple times doing it, just the exploring, I guess similar to like when I said Grand Theft Auto got me back into video games a long time ago, just being able to explore and look around, kind of doing what we're doing right now, was just mesmerizing to me. And do we have any witch hides? It was a lot of fun. So from there, I started watching other people's YouTube videos and learning more about the game. And, you know, as it's, you find that it's, oh, it's nighttime, we gotta sleep, that it's more and more complex. It just really, really took my interest. And I've always kind of been with YouTube under the impression that you want to do things that you enjoy doing. I really don't ever want to be uploading something beyond the point that I don't enjoy playing the game. You know, not just because of the enjoyment factor, you know, of it myself, but as you, the viewer, watching something that I'm also loving to do is important to me. So that's why I stopped doing Pokemon. I just stopped really enjoying at least the competitive battling aspect of it. And it's also, you've seen me slowly fading into doing more and more Feed the Beast videos. I currently enjoy playing Feed the Beast a lot more than vanilla, and it's mostly because it adds more to the game. I like new things happening instead of old things, you know, just something that I learn something new every day. Not, you know, with vanilla, you learn something new all the time. There's still a lot I don't know. But it's much bigger things that you find out about. So many new mobs, new dimensions, all sorts of stuff. And some people don't like it. I tend to think that more people tend not to like it because of the factor. Some people don't like when there's new things. They like knowing everything about the game. Other people, their computers just can't handle it. And, I'll tell you, it really helped being able to use my brother's laptop when playing Feed the Beast. Of course, he's letting me use it because he's getting his master's in school. In fact, he just finished, so this is perfect timing for the computer, because he's going to be asking for it back after, like, any, probably day now. He's on summer break, just waiting for his new job to start. But, yeah, so that rambled on for much longer than I probably should have. Let's move on. Let's try and bang through a couple of them. So, as far as the Pokemon stuff, a lot of people ask me, am I ever going to do Pokemon and YouTube again? The answer is probably not. I may end up doing a Let's Play in the future, but as far as competitive battling, I really don't see that happening. I kind of want to put it behind me, not in a bad way, but just kind of, I've been there, done that, and I'm ready to move on. If anything, I still see Minecraft going on for a lot longer time, but someday I'm not going to be doing Minecraft things, and I'll be playing the next game that I'm really enjoying and into, and that's how I always want to keep it, is what I currently like to play. And right now, Minecraft is about the only game I play. Other people ask, what other games do I play? Skyrim's been a big one for me. And I unfortunately got back into it again on the PC version. Don't know if I'm ever going to YouTube it. I wouldn't mind hearing what you guys have to say. And I have asked this question before in the past. Will I, do I plan to? And I've, yeah. I still might. I might do it where it's just like a single quest line instead of like trying to start from the beginning. I may start like kind of in the middle and just do like, you know, the assassins thingy or the, I don't know, do one quest line. And I see how that does, you know, have it maybe like 20 episodes and people like it, then start up another one. Maybe I'll have a different character in each one. But either way, I really don't know. I'm kind of interested in the new MMO coming out from the Skyrim people. What is it? Bethesda. So we'll see how that goes. That's another possibility. MMOs, though, they're hard to YouTube. I think they're much better for streaming, which is kind of why I really haven't gotten into... why am I killing sheep? I haven't gotten into Cube World. I did buy the game. I played it for about 10 minutes. That's it. And when I came to the conclusion that it's not really the best game for YouTube, I kind of put it behind me. I can't believe we still haven't found a mule yet. I kind of put it behind me, and I may get into it. Yes, we found it! I may get into it if I start streaming, but I don't think it's going to make the best YouTube series. All right. Oh, listen to them. Meow, meow. Oh, you're so cute, the baby mule. All right, so what's the deal with you guys? Let's tame these guys real quick. Oh, that was an awful sound. It's like, oh, my back. It hurts. It hurts. Oh, you're awesome. All right, people asking. That's enough about all the video game stuff. What's going on with your girlfriend? You haven't talked about your girlfriend in forever. Yes, I still have a girlfriend. And yes, I haven't talked about her. You're about as fast as my horse was. And you jump so lame. Still have a girlfriend. She's doing her thing. And I'm doing my thing. You know what? We're going to take a quick break. I'll be right back and we'll continue on with that question. All right, guys, sorry about that. Quick bathroom break. I checked on the time. I can't believe it. We're already over the 30-minute mark, so we're going to have to end momentarily. Let's just see what's up with this donkey. What's your jumping? I think all donkeys suck at jumping. This guy only seems like he's maybe a buck. Let's see if he can do 1.5. Oh, he can go 1.5. Let's just check out the other one. We were just talking about my girlfriend, and I thought, you know what, I'm going to try. She's at work right now, but just for fun, because probably half of you don't even believe me that I have a girlfriend, but I'll try and either, I'll see if she'll come over later, and to, I don't know, a little while of an episode with us, or maybe I can get her up on speakerphone, and she can come on. And we can start off a couple questions about her and what's going on. If she'll ever do a video with me. Oh, did I do the right donkey? If she'll ever do a video with me. As far as questions, I haven't even gotten through half of them. We're definitely not going to finish them all. But I think we're going to extend this walkie-talkie to one more episode. One more. I won't kill it like I did last time. Let's just get this guy friendly. We'll do one more, and I'll try and get her in on some of it. And I'll try and bang through the questions quicker. It'll mostly be our journey home with Mr. Jackass right here. Oh, you love us now. Let's see. This guy seems about as fast. Are these guys? Yep, they're donkeys. They're not mules. We have to breed them to make a mule. All right, you're about the same as what that other guy was. Nothing special. You have a little bit less health. Let's get down another fence post. And we will just leave it right here. As far as new, I still am taking donations. And again, that's only just to help me get some of the final things for the computer. I want to end up having 2 monitors and everything. But for the most part, our donations are pretty much slowing down and stopping and pretty soon go away.
altogether. We're not obviously anywhere near the donations monument. So hopefully at the end of next episode, once we get back home, I can update all the new donors from since last episode, as well as into the next. So anyway, guys, thank you all so much. And who knows, maybe next episode will actually be on my new computer. That would be freaking awesome. What do you think, huh? Would that be good? That'd be good. Yeah. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. As always, comment, like, subscribe, and peace out.